In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the Easter mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Kyrie eleison. Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christe eleison. Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Kyrie eleison. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial clothes there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord. Why did Mary of Magdala go to the tomb early in the morning that first day of the week? Did she feel as though she had left something behind? After all, it all happened so fast. The scattering of the disciples, our quick departure from campus. Yes, there's a sense of something left behind, but she also intuits a way forward. Maya Pace, she's a Torero women's basketball player. For me, she is a figure of Mary of Magdala. Why? Because she acknowledges the emptiness of lost opportunities while also showing us all a way forward. She writes, "What was taken away from us at the end of our season pales in comparison to what you gave us all year long. You gave me a platform to play and compete. You gave me the best teammates. You surrounded me with the most amazing people that know how to get me through the hardest days and make the great days and great moments even happier, funnier, and sweeter. Despite the bitter end to our season, I want to thank you once more for leaving me hungry and determined." What are you hungry for? What are you determined to embrace and engage when we get through this pandemic? What are you most looking forward to? Imagine that first pitch in the baseball season, the return of the performing arts. Imagine kissing your grandparent on the cheek, or going out to dinner with your friends at a restaurant? Do you hunger for the Eucharist? See it, believe it, imagine and believe. Our second reading encourages us not only to see beyond the trial of these days by looking forward to next season, the summer, next semester, the return to normalcy, or just getting out of the house. The reading encourages us to look even further beyond. St. Paul says, "Brothers and sisters, if then you are raised with Christ, seek what is above." Think about what is above, not what is on earth. Seek God. Think about heaven, eternal life. The first Easter did not happen at a church. It happened at an empty tomb while the disciples are at home, stricken with grief, wondering what's going on. This Easter, you too are at home, wondering what's going on. Maybe at times, like me, you feel the darkness of confusion, the grief of loss, the anxiety that comes with unanswered questions. How wonderful it is then to think, to imagine what is above, the light, the happiness, the peace of heaven. Yet, as we think of what is above, we can become more aware of the Holy Spirit dwelling within us and among us. The Holy Spirit is the gift of God given to us, that comes to us through the Paschal mystery, the dying and the rising of Christ. We are Christians, anointed with the same Holy Spirit, and called to do good, or at least not to do harm. When we do the truth in love, we believe. And when we trust, it's easier to love. Mary Magdalene was the first to see the stone rolled back, the empty tomb. She went that morning to reflect on what was left behind, but showed the way forward. See and believe. Imagine and believe. The Lord is risen, and we will rise together too. And together we'll profess our Easter faith by saying the Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Gathered together as brothers and sisters around Christ, our risen Lord, we make our needs known, our needs and the needs of a hurting world known to God our Father.
For the church throughout the world, on this Easter day, may Christians everywhere experience the joy of the risen Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those desiring to receive the sacraments of initiation, may they be blessed with patience as they wait to enter more fully into the life of the church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all members of the USD Founders Chapel community, even as we are separate, may the joy of this Easter season encourage us to grow closer to Jesus, so that like him, we can bring light and life to the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, may people around the globe be strengthened and sustained by hope as we continue to overcome the many challenges caused by this pandemic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, may all those who are ill, especially those infected with the coronavirus, be held in love and receive the care they need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For nurses, doctors, paramedics, for those who have died, especially members of our family members and our close friends. May they rejoice in God's promise of eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear the prayers of your church. May through Jesus, your Son, our risen Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have this bread to offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Lord, wash away thy iniquity. And cleanse me from my sins. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, gathered here and remotely, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the risen Lord be with you always. And please share a sign of peace with your family members and friends at home. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May the grace of this Paschal Sacrament abound in our minds, we pray, O Lord, and make those you have set on the way of eternal salvation worthy of your gifts. Through Christ our Lord. Expand that just a little bit. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ, alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God, alleluia, alleluia.
Thank you.